If I could be a symbolic British maiden, who would I be? I suppose you'd have to throw Florence Nightingale. I think I've always been sort of attracted to this idea of sort of a warrior princess, so Boadicea would be good. Especially on the first record, we looked at a lot of Waterhouse, and I guess Ophelia is, you know, definitely an iconic British maiden of sorts, I suppose. And, I mean, she lives at the Tate, so she lives in London, and not far from me. I guess you've got a mixture of nurse, warrior princess, and tragic heroine in there. Not sure how I fit the nurse in, but I guess that's also that you can have, it's got my name and Songbird in there, so it kind of makes sense. I tend to buy a lot of blouses, but a lot of kind of at the moment sort of almost 70s style collars, you know, the big pointy collars. In fact, I tend to find myself sort of caught in one colour palette. It really pleases me seeing like the lineup of shirts and like Gatsby, become Gatsby, all the shirts. I think the moment I probably felt most fashion, as it were, was coming out of that shell at Chanel. That was, and you're in the middle of the Grand Palais and the walk. I think the singing bit was almost, you could feel part of the installation, but then the walking, you know, with the models, that was terrifying. I was Queen of England for the day. I've always been interested in what her garden looks like. I'd probably go streaking through my own garden. So, you know, that big walled garden, so you'd just be running around completely naked in the middle of London, but because it was your own garden. I probably drink more tea than I do G&Ts nowadays, but probably would prefer a G&T right now.